way. Jobs and jokes to throw, that's the old way. It's like you're always stuck in second gear. When it hasn't been your day, we keep on moving your ear. But I'll be there for you.
We are the Sweet Company. Taz is the head chef, Caesar is the sales representative, and Tanner is the accountant, Spencer is the vice president, and I, Melissa, is the CEO. Our mission is that we strive to share a company's sweetness with every customer who will taste our yummy cookies. Our capital was $25, and we all contribute $5 to split the capital.
Hi, my name is Taz. This is our Ghirardelli cookie, brownie cookie recipe. We chose this cookie because we wanted to do something different. Our recipe is the Ghirardelli brownie mix. We need 2 boxes of them. We had all-purpose flour, 4 eggs, 8 ounces of butter, 12 ounces of chocolate chips, 2/3 ounces of vanilla extract, and 4 ounces of water. This recipe roughly makes 53 cookies. So for the manufacturing process, we have prepared the dough, and then we portion the dough using a scoop. We bake the cookies at 350 for about 11 minutes, and then after they cool, we wrap them in saran wrap and put a ribbon on them to package for sale.
Hello, my name is Caesar, and I'm a sales rep here at the Sweet Company. And for our marketing strategy, we decided to go for a Disney theme to attract the customers in all kinds of age groups. We added props to our marketing. We brought in stuffed animals, we played Disney music, and we also drew a poster. And we also did dress-ups, in which most of us dressed up as Disney characters and interacted with different people, and that's how we sold most of our cookies.
Hi guys, I'm Spencer Duran. I'm the Vice President for the Sweet Company, and we're going to go over the financial statements today. So first we're going to take a look at the balance sheet, and so we started off with $25 as stock paid in capital from the owners, and that is reflected here in owner's equity. And also is embedded in the cash because that's what we started off with. Continuing on, assets, we had a profit of $29, so that is that $25 plus the $29 to give us the total cash that we have. We didn't have any accounts receivable. Our total assets ended up being $54 as a reflection of that. We had no liabilities, and owner's equity, as we already talked about, we had the paid-in capital of $25 and retained earnings of $29. From our profit, giving us a total equity of $54, and there you go, it all balances out. Hey guys, now we're looking at the income statement for the Sweet Company. So our sales revenue was $85, and in the beginning we were a startup company, so we had $0 of inventory, beginning inventory. The cost of goods to manufacture was $20.27, and the ending finished goods inventory were zero because we actually sold all of our product during the process of the project. So that brings our cost of goods sold to $20.27, which comes down for a gross profit of $64.73 once you take out our salary, wages, marketing, advertising kind of stuff, expenses, which was $35.73. It comes to a total operating income of $29 total. So we did all right. I love you, Tanner.
Hi, I'm Tanner Potasik.
Hello, Tanner.
I'm the accountant at the Sweet Company, and we're about to talk about variances. So we're going to start talking about the direct materials cost variance. That is calculated as actual cost minus standard cost multiplied by actual quantity. So our actual cost of direct materials per cookie is 17 cents, and we have the standard cost also as 17 cents per cookie. The actual quantity we made was 53 cookies, and since there's no difference in the actual cost to the standard cost, there was no cost variance for direct materials. We also have the direct materials efficiency variance, which is calculated as actual quantity minus standard quantity multiplied by standard cost. So we ended up making 53 cookies instead of the projected 48 cookies. And then we multiplied that by the 17 cents for direct materials per cookie. And so we have an 85 cent variance. And this is unfavorable because it cost us more money. Now we're going to talk about direct labor variance. We're first going to start with direct labor cost variance, which is the actual cost minus standard cost multiplied by the actual quantity. The actual cost per hour is $9.78 per hour, and this was what we budgeted it. And because of that, the cost variance is zero. For the direct labor efficiency variance, that is calculated as actual quantity minus standard quantity multiplied by standard cost. During the baking process, we expected to be working for an hour and a half, but instead we actually only worked for an hour. And so we have a efficiency variance as $4.89, and this is favorable to the company for cutting costs.
I'm here to bake cookies. Yeah, smells so good. I just don't have a stomach.
Is this working?
You should do it.
Why did it go so off?
Say your name and title.
I don't know my title.
What about you? Oh my god, fine.
Cookies!
How do you think about this? How do you feel about this, Melissa?
Wait, this is what I mean. Can I see this?
I thought
everybody... Save the video, we can put it in there.
I'm Tanner Potasik. I'm the accountant at the Sweet Tooth Company.
Can do this. That's not good at all.
Do it. We can cut that out. We can cut this out. It's okay.